Hi guys, it's Jillian here at onceuponatimefitness.com, and today I wanted to show you some hand gestures, some TPR, that you can use in your classroom that you may not have actually thought about. So the first one that I wanted to show you is I wanted to show you how you can count in Chinese using your hands. This is something that I actually love so much because when you're using your hands in Western culture, it takes all 10 fingers to count to 10, so you can't count to 20 on your hands. Whereas in Chinese culture, it only takes your one hand to count to 10, so you can count all the way up to 99, which is really helpful when you're teaching the kids that are counting higher numbers. So there are two different ways to do it, but to make it easier and not confuse you, I'm just gonna show you the one way. And you're going to count to four the regular way, five, regular, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So then when you go to count to 11, this is my right hand. I don't know if the camera flips this for you or not, but I do it backwards. So I'm like, if I'm doing 12, I'm looking at 2, 1 in front of my face because the camera's going to flip it for my students. So they see everything the way that you're supposed to see it. So I do 12, 46, 99. You can count all the way up to 99 using your hands, and it's not complicated. Once you know the difference, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Super easy, and I love it. The next thing I wanted to show you was a heart. So you can do this. This is recognized as the heart, but if you ever see a student do this to you, that is a heart too. That means I love you, or heart, or whatever. So you can also do that. It's just your two fingers together, it makes a heart. Another thing that's really cool, and I recently learned this, I've been teaching for a year and I recently learned this, but in China, they actually learn the months of the year the same way that we do, on our knuckles, which is really cool. So you probably remember doing this, right? January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. They do the same thing. So many times they will have the month that they flipped around from what is normal for me because I'm an American. So I do, like if I'm doing May 1st, I will write 5-1. Whereas somebody in another country might write 1-5. They might write the day first. And that is the case in, depending on where they're learning things, that is the case in some Chinese schools. When they teach them this, they will still write it with the day first and then the month second. So if you're teaching them something that has to do with the months of the year, and you're confusing them when you write it out because they're putting the day first, you can always do it like this. I don't know, January, February, March, April, May. And they, 5, May. You can do it on your knuckles, and 9 times out of 10, they're going to understand because they learned it that way in school too. And that's all I've got for you today. Good job. Awesome. Yeah. Go have fun in your classes. The counting is something that I just find so simple. I even use it with my own kids now. I think it is the easiest way to count, and I prefer it so much more than doing it with two hands. Because the other thing is, I can also, when I'm doing this, I can also circle things on the screen too. So if I'm counting, I can say, where's my pen? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I can do it with one hand while I'm counting, and I don't have to, try to do it with two hands. Or I'm just kidding, I would never do that. But it does make it really convenient, and I love that one, and I am so glad that that's something that I learned early on. And that's all I've got for you for today. Make sure you hit subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys!